What's up, my fellow programmers? Hope you guys are doing well. Today, I'm going to show you how to use Cursor and the Framelink Figma MCP to design your website super fast. We'll be building a login page from scratch, and I'll walk you through everything from setting up the MCP and getting it up running and smoothly. Stick around till the end for some tips and tricks to help you get the most out of it. So, let's get started. So to get started, you just need to go to this link. I'll have the link in the description. It's very easy to set up. The only thing that you have to make sure is to have like Cursor. If you're on Mac, you have to add this in your MCP JSON. Or if you're on Windows, then you'll just have to add this. And it's very simple. You just have to go to your settings, MCP. And you can see that I already have it enabled here. But if you don't, then you can just click here. So you should have an empty file. So once you paste this code from here, the only thing you'll need now is your Figma API key. And you can find it on figma.com. So one, you have to be logged into your Figma account. Click on the profile section, go to settings, security. And you can see here, personal access tokens. So just click on generate new token. You can give it all of the access. So once you do that, you also have, don't forget to name it. So I'll name it Framelink YouTube. I'll click on generate token. You can see that the token has been generated. I'll copy this token and paste it here. So once that is done, just make sure to save it and restart your cursor just to be safe, because for me, I found that it works when I reset my cursor. So let's go back to MCP. You can see that it's being started here. So I do have a Figma design picked out. So we'll be trying to create this login screen. So to use this MCP, it's very simple. All you have to do is select the screen that you want to create, right click, go to this copy/paste as, copy link to selection, and you'll get a URL that links to this specific page. And you just have to open your agent mode. You can have it on any, but I'd recommend using Claude 3.7. And you can just paste the link here and you can say, hi, can you please create this in HTML, CSS, and JS? You can use any framework. Like if you're using React, you can give it the context of React. If you're using React Native, you could do that. So whatever project you're working on, you just have to give context on that. But to just keep things simple and focus more on the Figma MCP, I'm just asking it to create it in HTML and CSS. So I'll click on send and you can see that it's asking me to run the tool. I'll click on run tool. So run tool, it's downloading the image assets. So let's see if it is able to download the assets, because sometimes it fails to download them. But sometimes I found that they are able to download them fine. So let's just see. So you can see it has started creating the files. I'll click accept. So now you can see that it has finished creating the website for us. You can see that first it ran the get Figma data, from which it was able to get the structure and the colors and everything from. And then it ran the download Figma images, which I think didn't work as expected. So then it just created the files. So let's just see. And yeah, so now you can see that it has done like 80% of your work. It even used an image from the internet, because I believe it wasn't able to export this image. There might have been a permission issue. Yeah, but I'm able to export it fine. So you can see that it has copied all of the texts and their styling as well. Email, please enter your email. It even added the eye icon. And it is functional as well. Forgot password. You can see like it's like really similar to Figma. This was a like very basic example. So now you just saw like how the Framelink Figma MCP works. If you're having any issues, please drop your questions and issues in the comment section below. I'll try out my best to help you guys. And while you're at it, don't forget to subscribe and press that like button and share it with your friends as well. And now for some tips and tricks to get the most out of it. So when you're working with large projects such as React Native or React or Vue.js projects that have like similar design structures, so what I would recommend you do is you give context of that page. Like for example, if you go here, let's just think that this is a new screen. So you can see that most of the components are similar here. So what I would do if I wanted to create this screen, I would tell the Figma MCP, like I would tell my agent and give it context. Like I'd press add and I'd add the file reference like index.html, and I would say use index.html as a reference and create a sign up page. And if you have a images folder or if fonts, I would also give the context of that, like use the fonts from at fonts if there is any, or like if you have a static colors file, I would add colors here as well. So now you can see that I've asked it to create a simple sign up page using that as a reference. And let's just wait and see how well it performs. So it has created the sign up page. So let's try and access that as well. Like you guys just saw, this tool is a game changer. It's a seriously powerful addition to your arsenal, especially when you're working on larger projects. If you've got any questions related to this, just drop them in the comments. I got you. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video.